The purpose of this video is to show you how to use Microsoft Teams with your students. Your students can access Microsoft Teams by clicking on the link that you provide on your Canvas page. See my video on how to create and share links to see how to do this. So let's assume that you and the student have already entered the chat. The chat will look something like this. There'll be buttons right here. You're going to see your student right here, and then you will be in the bottom right-hand corner. Let's look at the student's view. Okay, again, on the student screen, you are right here. The student would be in the bottom right-hand corner. So one of the first things I recommend you doing is that you need to be on Google Chrome. If you are not using the Google Chrome browser, Teams probably won't work, so get on Google Chrome. Next, before you chat with your students, I recommend that you pull up the links that you want to show them. So today, I want to show my student this Pete the Cat book. I want to show my student our letter of the day for foundations. And I want my student to watch a video on how to make the letter K. Okay. So I'm going to go back to my chat. Here's my screen. In order to share with my student, I'm going to click the share button, the rectangle with the arrow. I want to share my screen. There's some other things you can do too. You can share a PowerPoint that you've downloaded. You can play around with the whiteboard, which is where students and you can draw things for each other to see. But for the purpose of this video, we are going to use screen share. So I'm going to click on screen share. It's going to prompt me to do something. When I click on screen share, my student will not be able to see me, but they should still be able to hear me. So I'm going to click on screen share. It's going to ask me, how do you want to share your screen? Do you want the student to see your entire screen? Do you want them to see your window or the Chrome tab? I recommend the Chrome tab because you can pick which tab they will see. So I want to read that Pete the Cat story to my student. I'm going to hit that link, that tab where the story is, I'm gonna hit share. So now on my student's screen, look what happens. My student sees the Pete the Cat book that I want to read to them, and they can hear me reading. So if I turn to the first page of the Pete the Cat book, remember, I'm still sharing, I'm still on video. It's just showing the student my screen, okay? Because if I go back here, I'm still on the video. So I'm going to the screen. It says sharing this tab to Teams. So again, look at my student's screen. They can see what I can see. And now I can read them the story. This is Epic Books. It's a wonderful website. As a teacher, you have access to lots of free great books, and it will read it to them, or you can read it to them, and you can highlight words. So I'm going to read my student this page. Here comes Pete. It is lunchtime. Pete is ready to eat. My student can see it. Watch. Here comes Pete. See how all the letters light up or get bigger on their screen? They're seeing and hearing exactly what I am doing on my screen. So let's say I finish the story and I'm done sharing this screen. I want to see their faces. I'm gonna hit stop. I'm gonna go back to my Microsoft Teams tab and I need to turn my camera back on. Okay, now we're gonna look at the student's screen. They can see me again. Now I want to share our foundations letter with them. So I'm going to click on the tab where I put my foundations letter. Oh, excuse me. I need to click on share first, screen share, Chrome tab. Now I click on that tab where the picture is. I'm gonna hit share, sharing this tab to Teams. If you look on the student's screen, they can see it. So I can show them, I can say, look at this. This is uppercase K. This is lowercase K. K, kite, k. When I'm done showing them the letter, I can hit stop. The last thing I want to show my students is a video on how to make the letter K that I found on YouTube. So I am going to hit share. I'm going to hit screen share. I'm going to Chrome tab, and I'm going to click on that YouTube tab that I pulled up. I'm going to hit share. So now my student will be able to see the video. I'm going to play it for them. Look, it's on their screen.
Uppercase K, point to the skyline, go down to the grass line, leave a space, and point to the skyline. Slide back to the plain line, slide over to the grass line. Say K, kite, k.
Okay, my students saw that foundations video. We are finished. I'm gonna hit stop sharing. And I'm gonna go back to Microsoft Teams. I need to make sure I turn my camera back on and my sound. Because remember, this button turns your camera on and off. This button turns your sound on and off, okay? The last thing I'll show you is that while you're working with your students, if you want to start a conversation where everyone can watch and participate, they can start a chat. So you can say to your students, what is your favorite color? Whoops, color. And hit enter. And now, look at your student's computer. See the red dot that appeared over the note? It says show conversation. If they click on it, they can see my question. They can like it, and they can reply. So I'm gonna have the student reply red. Enter. Now, if I come back, the student told me red. If I'm finished with the conversation, I can exit out. But remember, this entire time that I've been showing all of these different things, we have been on video. We have been doing a video call. So those are some basic ways you can use Microsoft Teams with your students. There are more advanced ways, but again, this is more of a beginner video. I highly recommend once you get comfortable with Teams, you start sharing your screen to share some really awesome different things that you can find on the internet with your students so that when you're sharing it with them, you can verbally explain what it is. I'm gonna provide a very short clip at the end of this video that will show you how I used Microsoft Teams and screen share to read a book and work on comprehension with one of my students. And my student's parent did give permission for you to hear the audio that you'll hear in this video. I hope this helped. Please let me know.
What's this?
A sandwich.
A sandwich. All right, let's turn the page. Yes. Pete wants a sandwich. Pete opens the fridge. Tracy, why did he open the fridge?
But he wants to get the sandwich.
Good listening, Gracie. He opened the fridge because he wants to get the sandwich. Excellent. All right. He takes out a loaf of bread. He finds a yummy fish. He adds tomato and mayo. So what is he doing, Gracie?
He wants to make a fish.
Well, he wants to put the fish in the sandwich. So he grabbed all of the things that he needed for his sandwich. What did he get? He got a... What's this?
fish.
And on
tomato.
Tomato, good girl. This is bread and this is mayo. Let's turn the page. He looks at his sandwich. Oh no, it is too small. Something is missing. Gracie, what's wrong with Pete's sandwich? Why? Tell me.
But he wants to open the sandwich.
Well, he wants to make the sandwich, but what happened? Why is he sad? Because the sandwich is too small. Good job, Gracie. The sandwich is too small. Pete knows what it needs. His sandwich needs an apple. Pete loves apples. Gracie, what does the sandwich need?
To get the apple.
To get the apple. Excellent listening. His sandwich needs crackers. Crackers are crunchy. Pete loves crunchy crackers. Pete looks at